Ollie, what can Meghan do to improve her image? She keeps winning daft awards, but these meaningless honours aren't fooling anyone.
Well, she's really damaged her own image. I mean, we've seen how privileged she is. She's living in a Montecito mansion. She's got a royal title. And all she seems to do is complain and moan about how difficult her life is. And I think she's really out of touch because I saw her Netflix series with Harry and Meghan. I just thought it was really boring, to be honest, because, look, they got paid $100 million for that. I mean, they thought they were going to be the new Kardashians. There was no drama. It was literally them. Not even in their own house. They actually put up a picture of Princess Diana on the wall, pretending it was their house. It wasn't even their own house. So I think because Meghan has no authenticity, people see this kind of false veneer. It's not a real person. She's just using Harry and stuff. So I think that looks bad. And interestingly today, the CEO of United Talent Agency, one of the top three biggest talent agencies in Hollywood, actually called her talentless. He basically said she's not a great audio talent. She's not a great talent at all. And just because she's famous doesn't mean she has any talent. So that's very telling from one of the biggest talent agencies. She's been dropped by Spotify. Dan Wootton, the Daily Mail columnist, said today that there's talk of Netflix dropping them because they haven't delivered on their promises. So I think people have just got fatigue. They see her privilege. They see her constantly whining and moaning and all this wokeness. And she's just so out of touch.
Oh, you wrapped it up right then and there. Ollie London, thank you so much for joining me today.